authentication attacks. So we're still in our first section of the course, which means all the attacks that we're going to talk about are attacks that we can launch on any network that is within our Wi-Fi range, even if the network has encryption, even if it uses a key, and even if we don't have that key. So we don't have to connect to any network to launch these attacks. The deauthentication attack is very useful. It allows us to disconnect any device from any network that is within our Wi-Fi range. To do this, we're going to spoof our MAC address to the target client MAC address. So the target client is the client that we want to disconnect. We're going to pretend to be him, and we're going to send a deauthentication packet to the router. So we're going to tell the router, I want to disconnect from you. At the same time, we're going to spoof our MAC address to the access point MAC address, to the router's MAC address, and tell the target client, the client that we want to disconnect, we're going to tell him, you need to re-authenticate yourself. So when we do this, we're going to successfully disconnect the target client. So we're going to pretend to be the target client and tell the access point that we need to disconnect from you, we want to disconnect from you. And then we're going to pretend to be the access point and tell the client, you need to reconnect, if you need to re-authenticate yourself. When we do that, the connection is lost. We're going to use a tool called AirplayNG to do it. So let's see how we can do that. First of all, we're going to need to run AeroDumpNG on the target network, because we want to see which clients are connected to it. So we want to see what devices are connected to this network. So our first command is going to be AeroDumpNG. And I'm not going to need the write option, so I'm just going to delete it here. So all I'm going to need is AeroDumpNG channel. We put the channel of the target network, and BSSID, the MAC address of the target network. And we hit enter. And now we're sniffing on my target network, which is UPC 62. So my target device is going to be this device. This method would work on any device, whether it's a Linux, Windows, Mac, if it's a phone, Android, iOS, it doesn't matter. They all use the same method of transferring packets, so it's going to work on any Wi-Fi enabled device. Let's make sure we have connection here. I'm just going to go to google.com. Make sure I'm connected to the internet. Okay, so we see now that Google is working perfectly. Let's go back here. And I'm gonna split the screen here. So we're gonna run AirplayNG now to disassociate one of the devices from the network. We can run it to disassociate all devices, but I found when I do that, it doesn't really disassociate all of them, because we have too many targets to disassociate. So I'm gonna choose one target, which is going to be this device, the device that we just saw. So it's going to be AirplayNG, and then we're gonna deauthentication attack, and then we're gonna put the number of deauthentication packets that we're going to send. So I just put a very large number to keep the device disconnected. Then we're going to put the target access point. So it's the MAC address of our target access point. This is it. And then we're going to put the source or the client MAC address. That's the device that we want to disconnect. And it's this device here. So I put its MAC address there, and I'm just going to put 10 my Wi-Fi card with monitor mode. So again, AirplayNG, the auth, the number of packets, then we put the MAC address of the target AP, and then the MAC address of the device that we want to disconnect. I'm gonna hit enter, and AirplayNG now send in the authentication packets. Let's go to the target device and see if we still have internet connection. And as you can see, we lost our connection, and it's now trying to reconnect. It's not going to be able to reconnect, because we're still sending the authentication packets, so this device is successfully disconnected, and we can launch this attack on any network that we want without we don't need to know the username, we don't need to know the password or the key to that network.
Click here for the next video and click here for the previous video, or go to description for the video link. A link was provided in the description below for all of my other videos on cracking Wi-Fi passwords. Please like this video and thank you for watching.